got shot. Sitting backstage, we waited on the show to start. Glad y'all came here. Glad y'all came to support me.
Enjoy the show tonight. All right, I sound like you're ready to enjoy the show tonight. Some saints and some friends, so I'm gonna say praise the Lord. All right, check the house and then for those, what's up, what's good? All right, we in the house tonight. All right, I'm going to, well, for those of you that don't know who I am Darren Crawford. I'm your MC for tonight. Is that all right? Y'all gonna let me practice on y'all? This is kind of new for me because I'm on the singing end, but I'm not doing that tonight, so. If y'all don't throw me no tomatoes or nothing at me. Because y'all couldn't have no food in here, no how. All right. At this time, we're going to get started. We're going to ask for little Brandon Jr. to come and give us a welcome. And while he's coming, he had me cracking up last Sunday in church because Brandon had told him his dad, he was, you know, being kind of loud in church, and his dad went over there and told him, told him to be quiet, and he looked at his dad and he said, shh, shh, shh. So let's say hi to Brandon.
We gonna make this real fast because I ain't had no medication and I'm tired and I'm ready to go. Y'all give it up again for Darren, y'all. That's my MC and my friend. I would have had somebody else to do it, but the money ran low, so that's all I could afford. You know I got shot. The name of the show is You Know I Got Shot, and that's pretty much my excuse for everything, since I got shot. My wife came home back when Brandon Jr. was a baby. Baby ain't been changed all day. She asked me, why the baby doodle got, you know, got doodle on his booty? I said, baby, you know I got shot. She don't even care. The IRS say, Brandon, you ain't paid your taxes in 6 years. You know I got shot. They said, but you got shot 3 years ago. And you ain't been your taxes in 6 years. Still, you know I got shot. I don't care what it is, the excuse is you know I got shot. And see, I was new to this hospital thing, because before I got shot, I only think I got inoculated when I was a baby. I have never been to the hospital. And so, I go to the hospital, and Lord, y'all heard of morphine? I say, have you heard of morphine? Morphine, iphine, euphine, morphine. Morphine. And they messed around and gave me a morphine drip. Now, you know it was the county hospital because I'm paralyzed, and they gave me a button to press if I needed more morphine. And so I'm in there, and I press the button, and the morphine hits me. And I didn't know whether to run doodle or go blind. Man, that morphine was so good. I mean, Jesus. Y'all, I'm sorry, y'all, I need a minute. They gave me the morphine. I forgot I was on earth. And so I started having all these crazy dreams and stuff like that. And in the dreams, I wasn't even paralyzed. The morphine was just that good. And so y'all know who Joel Osteen is, right? Y'all know Joel Osteen has got to be the happiest man in the world. That y'all clapping, that stuff don't come to you, never mind. But anyway, when they gave me the morphine, I felt like Joel Osteen. And they could have came and said, Brandon, your house just caught on fire. And I'd have hit that morphine button and I said, that's all right. Because you know, fire is good. Fire comes from God. You know, Jeremiah said it's like fire in my bones. Fire keeps you warm. We all like being warm. But Brennan, you lost everything. That's okay, it's just things. We can always go buy more things. We can even buy morphine. Morphine things. And so I was wondering, because it's so many different species of animals. Animals. I might be on morphine right now. Y'all don't know. It might be. Now don't talk to me no more. I ain't ask you no questions. Now, I know I can't stand that. I be up here, now I ain't did comedy since, I need a morphine drip. I ain't did comedy since 2004, because, well, seriously, I did get shot. Now, I was born and raised in North Las Vegas, and you, yeah, okay. And, you know, we call it North Town. And you know, in North Town, they will steal the color off of black. They will steal anything in North Town. And so, I met my wife. Well, she wasn't my wife at first, she was my girlfriend. But she became my wife. And so I met my girlfriend, and the plan was, we gonna do this thing right. We ain't gonna have no sex. I couldn't say that with a straight face. We ain't gonna have no sex until we get married. And that's twice. We gonna do this thing right. We gonna get married in September. And when we finally get married, We gonna do the thing on our wedding night. It's gonna be beautiful because we waited, and the Lord's gonna. That's not gonna happen. and it's gonna be beautiful and all that stuff. So we was doing good for like 2 months, y'all. Maybe 2.5. And so her parents set me up. I'm gonna talk about my in-laws later on in the show. So, her parents had to go out of town. And they said, Brandon, you can come and stay tonight if you want to. They just gave me the stuff. I had to come. You know, somebody daddy give you something. He didn't want to help make it, so he gotta give it to you. And so they said, Brandon, you can go on and stay here with Shadara while we go out of town. Lord, are you testing me? Are you trying to see, do I love you? Because I love you, but I also love other things. And so, we are there, and her parents had left, and we are in her bedroom. The den of a nickel's butt. So we in her bedroom. And so we laying there in the bed, and we're not having sex, because see, my wife was serious about the Lord. I had a good fondness of her, but she was serious about the Lord. I mean, it took like a month and a half just to get some sugar. And so we laying in bed, and I'm holding her, right? And all the fellas know how it is when you know, and you got to hope it's with, you got to have your booty sticking out so you don't make no contact. And so, yeah, I can't say it to the kids in the room, but just let your mind, some of y'all minds even got to go that far. Some of y'all go, I'm with you, Brandon. Okay. And so we laying in bed, and I'm hugging her, right? And I start rubbing her back. So you know it. And so she tells me, you better stop touching me like that. said, you better stop touching me like that or... She... Okay.
All right.
I just let you know that they don't arrest people in wheelchairs. And so she said... And so, anyway, so she says to me, you better stop touching me like that, or you're gonna have to marry me. Because, you know, she wanted to be fruitful and multiply at that point. And so I say, okay, go and get up, throw something on, we're going downtown, and we're gonna get married. Right? And so, this is the truth how it happened. And so she gets dressed, and we hop in my car, and we driving downtown to get married. Now see, I'm not thinking clearly, because I'll just say I needed some iron, because the blood was low. And so we go down to the courthouse, downtown. I walk in there, I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna marry this girl, and I'm finna get lucky, and we just gonna go and do what we do. We can do it now, not it, you know, we can do other things because we're now married. And y'all who weren't virgins before y'all got married, guilt-free sex is wonderful. And so, yes, y'all put back on that. Y'all know. Y'all be still trying to act so modest. Y'all some of the biggest freaks. Y'all know when y'all be doing a job, doing somebody say is it good, you know what I'm saying? Amen. And so anyway, because y'all front, I'm going to talk to this side, because they don't know, they fronting over there. And so, she said that she, I ain't going to let me get my thoughts. She told me, okay. So she said, so we go downtown, and we get our marriage license. So didn't nobody tell me that once you get your marriage license, that you're not married. Because when you go get your driver's license, when you leave, you can drive a car. So I'm thinking when I get my marriage license, I can drive a car. So they tell me, so I find out, we're not, well, okay, I can tell the truth now. I already knew, but she ain't know. And so, but I'm telling you, can I be honest?
Yeah.
We got a confession, now don't tell the Lord, I'm telling y'all. And so, mama, that's two. And so, we go down, hang on, because her daddy is in here. And so, Uncle Patrick, wave your hand, Uncle Patrick, but yeah. Okay, y'all don't tell him. And so, we go downtown and we get the marriage license and we get on back to the house and we can't do nothing. And so I'm mad as R. Kelly at a 21 and over party. I mean, I'm heated, because I done got this license, and I can't even drive. So then days later, we go down to, where did we go? We went somewhere, and I had just got off work, and I had a long day at work. I went and picked up, we went downtown, we got married. I says, what we gonna do? We're gonna go on and do what we do. And we ain't gonna tell nobody. We're gonna go on and have our marriage ceremony in September. So at the time, I wanted a Chrysler 300. And I went down there and I test drove one. Lord, do y'all know what a Chrysler 300 is? That car. And I was loving it because y'all see how big I am. Anytime something makes me feel small, I like it. I like it. And so I got the price of it, I had to slide the seat up, and I ain't never did that. And so I was getting my Chrysler 300, and I was gonna get married. And so about 2 weeks later, She said, "Brandon." I said, "Huh?" She said, "My friend ain't come."
Uh-oh.
Now, this is my wife, so I'm told. And so she said, "Brandon, my friend ain't come." I said, "Do we have a cell phone?" Let's call him, see where he is. And so, she had got herself pregnant.
She got
messed up all my plans for the brother 300. And so, at the time, we were staying with my brother. And my brother is saved now. And if God has saved my brother, God will save anybody. My brother has so many females in and out the house. Some of y'all. But, that if I had been thinking, I could have charged admission. I could have been a madam. Well, you know, a Mr. Madam. And I forgot where I was going with this joke. Okay, I still don't remember, so I'll come back to that.
It's the morphine.
I know what I just said. Let me tell you how this works. My turn to talk, y'all turn to listen. I don't come on y'all job, knocking brooms out of y'all head. I don't come on y'all job, trying to find a french fries. So don't come on my job, somebody do my job. Understand? And so, my wife is not trying to live right. She trying, I'm giving it the best I can. And so, I went and talked to my brother. And I said, "Brent, that's my brother." Shador said, "A friend ain't come." He said, "Do we have a cell phone?" I said, "No." She said, "A friend ain't come. We getting ready to have, well, she getting ready to have, I'm gonna help her out. We can have a baby." And so he said, "What about the Chrysler?" And I thought about it. Chrysler 300? It'll be paid for in 5 years. A child you'll never finish growing. All that 18 years though, that's a lie. A child itself is good birth control. And so I said, "Okay, what we gonna do?" Cause she didn't wanna stay there. It wasn't nobody in the house but me, my brother, her 3 kids, my mama and them, a couple of Mexicans around the block. And so she says, "Too many people in here. We just sharing our bed before people flip." And so she says, "Too many people in here." So I said, "Okay, I'm gonna do what everybody else do, Brandon Sapp. I'm gonna do what everybody else do. I'm gonna move out where the white folks stay. I thought I was gonna be safe. It never dawned on me, if white folks will steal a whole country, then they don't mind stealing something from you." Now, I like white people, not nobody white in this room, other white folks. And so, I had a friend. I'm not gonna mention his name, because he's the one that basically got me shot. So I'm not gonna tell y'all his name. I'm not gonna tell that, Gary, I'm sorry. I'm not gonna mention his name. And so Gary had a wife. Oh, I'm sorry, I said his name. I did not mean to say Gary's name. And so, is he here tonight? Okay, Gary's wife was so ugly. Jesus. Okay, I'm not gonna say she was ugly, I'm just gonna say she wasn't camera ready. That's what you do. Nobody's ugly, they're just not what? So he say, we gonna move there across some streets. Now he said, first they were gonna move in the same complex, and they saw Gary and his wife, and they was like, so we can't have pets, we play. And so, what are you gonna do? You already shot me. And so, we there in the apartment, and Gary and his wife came to stay with us for a little while. I thought it was all cool, because my wife and I moved out to where the white folks was. So I'm feeling safe. I'm paying double the price for ground beef. I don't even care. Because I ain't got to worry about going outside and seeing somebody sitting on my car. I ain't got to worry about parking my car and coming outside and getting some flowers on it. No, I'm liking this. I almost start paying an association dues. And so that's a whole nother story. And so what happened was after that, Gary, my wife had to go to a debutante ball or something like that. And I was gonna go, but she had did her hair by herself. And I got a reputation to maintain. And so, so I said, I ain't going, because her hair looked like who did it in rain.
It was real good. What you think about the show?
I need a hot link.
What you think about the show?
Fabulous.
Sir, what you think about the show?
Real good, real good.
It's great.
Awesome. What you think about the show?
Very good.
Very good.
Congratulations.
What you guys think about the show?
Great. The party is funny.
What you guys think about the show?
Real good.
What do you think about the show?
It's awesome. Very funny.
Thank you.
I was funny, not him. I was funny.
Lady? You? Sister, what you think about the show?
I think it was amazing. I enjoyed it very much.
Thank you. What about the show?
I thought the show was great.
Since you family and all.
I thought it was great. Many more to come.
What you guys think about the show?
I thought it was awesome. It was really good. Brandon did a great job.
Thank you. You?
Very good. Not quite as wordy, but it's very good.
Uh-huh.
What's doing? What's doing? Say, I know my daddy got shot.
Oh, yeah, I got shot.
Say hi, Daddy.
Hi, Daddy.
You had a good show, Daddy.